In this tutorial, we will translate some DGN data representing city traffic lights to Esri shapefile. The traffic lights are represented by DGN cells. Since the shape format does not support the concept of cells, we will convert them to points and make the text next to the traffic signal an attribute of the points. Let's take a look at our DGN data in the FME Data Inspector. We will open it using the Bentley Microstation Design V8 reader. Then, for the dataset, select the trafficsignals.dgn file. If we just clicked OK, then FME would use the level number in the DGN file as the feature type name. However, we know that there is also a level name in the DGN data, and usually it's more intuitive to work with level names rather than numbers. So let's view the data again. This time, we will set up the reader to read the level names. We will go into the parameters and set the group elements by to level names. We can also set up the reader to read the insert points of the traffic signal cells, rather than the cells. Under Element Options, expand the Name Cells option, then check Preserve Name Cell Insert Points. Click OK. We can see that on the traffic signals level, we have the insertion point for the cell and the signal text. Let's get working with this in FME Workbench. We have set our reader format and dataset to read the traffic signals. Just as we did in the data inspector, we will set up the reader parameters to read the level names and the cells as points. We have also set our writer format to Esri shape and selected our output location for the dataset. We are only interested in the traffic signals feature type. So, within the Select Feature Types dialog window, we will uncheck Default. As you can see, FME Workbench automatically places a geometry filter on the canvas to separate the points from the text. This is because the shape format does not allow multiple geometries per file. Remember, our goal is to write points and to merge text onto the points as an attribute. So, we will delete the text output feature type. We will use a neighbor finder transformer to merge the text onto the points. The neighbor finder transformer finds the closest candidate feature within a specific maximum distance of each base feature. We want each base point to find one text candidate within a certain distance. But you may be asking, what should this distance be? We can use the FME Data Inspector to quickly do a rough measurement. By selecting the ruler tool and dragging a line between the two points, we can see that the distance appears to be just over 2 meters. Back in FME Workbench, within the Neighbor Finder parameters, we can set the maximum distance using the measurement we just took. Let's round this number to 3 meters. If we inspect the data at this point, we will see that FME has put the DGN text into an attribute called FME_text_string. Back in FME Workbench, we will use an attribute renamer to change the name to simply be text. Within the parameters, we can enter our original attribute name followed by the new one that we wish to apply. We also need to make sure that the destination shapefile has an attribute called text, which we can do within the user attributes. A width of 10 should be sufficient. Now we will run the workspace by clicking on the green play button. A quick inspection of the data shows us that we indeed have points in our shapefile, and that there is a new attribute called text.